Oh, yeah.
Coming and going from the encampment.
First announcement has been given.
So they've made the announcement.
Okay. We're recording.
I'll go ahead and turn it on. They didn't ask us to record, but I'll do it.
Okay.
Downlink is on, though.
Okay.
They have kind of like a makeshift wall built around here too.
Yeah, they did before too.
Were they putting up big tents? Is that what they put over the top of those tracks?
Yeah.
Those canvas.
They used to have a bunch of signs and stuff.
Okay. Try to turn down the brightness here so I can see what heat sources are. Those are canopy, I don't know, probably some kind of
from 5-2.
Propane heater maybe or something. Yeah, because there's the officers over there on 7th. And there's another group of them down here. So it looks like whoever's at this house is not an officer anyway, to be sure. There's more there, and then a bunch up here, so. I still don't have any movement inside there that you can really see. Every once in a while I see somebody go by one of the openings in the tents, but there's nothing really to report. There goes somebody there. Box of something. I don't know if that person is leaving the thing there.
Command TRV. Spotter observer noticed several keg size objects in the middle of the camp. Looks like one's maybe a beer keg. Doesn't know what could be inside.
Tell what he's doing there. There's an officer who's looking at him now, so.
We have people looking out the second floor window of the black house.
Mark Soper wants a call.
Maybe you can. I'll see if I think you can get him.
Hey, it's Elliot up in Smoky 3. Oh, yeah, we're overhead. Well, I guess Olympia PD's got a way to get the downlink, so yeah, they decided to not go with the little handheld. So I know Olympia PD's got some. Yeah, they told us that Olympia PD had a drone too. Yeah, I haven't seen it flying around yet, but yeah, we're here. So, okay, all right, thanks. All right, bye. They said they were informed that we were going to be up here. That was SOPR. They got the kind of the bomb contingency down there.
Union Pacific, second admonishment red.
Okay, so they've read the second one.
They've read the second one?
Second warning?
Yeah. They have to read the admonishment from Union Pacific, who owns the tracks. And I presume that they would have some other trespassing type order or something that they have to read out loud to them before they can
go in.
Clear the camp. That's a lot of junk. That's going to be a big
mess. Yeah, that'll take a while.
I still have individuals at the house. They're just watching right now. I don't see anything that I can tell. They were referring to the middle of the camp and some objects, but it's very indistinct. So I can't make anything out of the middle there.
Yeah. Yeah, we had a little bit more daylight last time we did this, so a little easier to see what they had there. Track the pilot view, but it's not showing up on the Wi-Fi lists.
Oh, okay. Weather looking good back there at Olympia still?
Yeah, that fog is getting a little bit closer. It's still just kind of west of the runway, but
all right.
Trying to keep the lights on every once in a while.
Yeah. Well, worst comes to worst, we could always divert somewhere else for a little bit. It's supposed to clear up, so.
Yeah.
Whoever that is very quiet. I can't hear him at all.
Yeah. How you doing on heat back there?
Oh, fine.
Starting to get a little warm. Let's see, cabin heat. Turn down a little bit.
Yeah, somebody's sitting on his microphone. I still can't see anything going on in these other tents. There's obviously heat, but I don't know what else.
Yeah.
I can't get a count on people or anything like that, so. can't tell if that's a separate tent. I think it is. Across the tracks. And there's one more over there.
Okay.
like he just read something else to him, so that'd probably be the third one.
Union Pacific, third notice has been read. It is time to deploy. Thurston County deploying.
Is anyone coming out of the tents, or are they still in there?
No, I haven't seen anybody come out yet, so either they're already vacated the tents, or I don't know. There's, I don't, maybe railroad workers or something with them who are actually doing the tear down of the stuff. They're just moving in from south to north. Basically.
Okay. Yeah, normally I can put this on your iPad. It's a lot easier to see, but
I'm
not working at the moment.
Yeah, they're just clearing as they go. This group here is starting to make entry to the main sort of complex there. If there's nobody left in there, that's even worrisome in a sense, because if they all left, they might have left little surprises behind.
Yeah.
So hopefully not. But yeah, so far I don't have anybody leaving anywhere.
I would think if someone was still in there, they would have come out by now.
Maybe. It's hard to say. Sometimes their tactic would be just to, passively lay there until somebody actually made the move, but
yeah.
They're obviously going to go through from one end to the other and just sort of clear everything. think they're actually cutting some of those tarps as they go.
We're starting to get a group gathering up at 7th and Adams. They're yelling at some people up here.
7th and Adams.
Copy. So far, there's nobody in the camp.
Yeah. I think that's the group he's referring to that's doing the yelling. Is empty.
Can we get a couple more officers down at 7th and Adams? They're yelling at the guy in the SWAT truck.
I'm not familiar with where the rail line runs after it goes underneath Jefferson.
Like northbound, or a bunch of people moving quick over here?
Yeah, those are bicycles.
Oh, that might be the officers. They wanted to go over to 7th and Adams, maybe?
Well, no, 7th and Adams is behind them.
Okay. Do they have to go around? Is this like an overpass up here? There's a SWAT truck. That's a Bearcat right there.
Yeah. This is what they're talking about here.
Yeah, this group.
There's more tents that go underneath, following the rail line that goes underneath Jefferson. I see one right there. So I don't know if there's more to clear underneath that way, but I'm not as familiar with where that rail line runs after it goes underneath there. I know it comes out towards Capitol Lake, but...
But that's an overpass, then.
Yeah, they're almost all the way through the camp, and there's nobody in there.
Maybe that group, that's their camp.
Well, I would imagine. I only see one more tent here. Then there's actually a tunnel. And I don't think they could go anywhere in there. These folks here all have cell phones out. That's probably the main group there.
Let PS back at IFR.
Okay.
Mile and 3/4.
I think it comes out. Yeah, that's where the rail line comes out. It's over here, so. It just runs underneath Adams Street, basically. They have a good officer presence up there at 7th and Adams, so I don't think it would be.
Okay.
There's not many people there. There's a few, but... We're not talking about a crowd of hundreds here. And nobody has any weapons or anything like that. It's just the usual cell phone filming.
Gotcha. It looks like they pretty much made it all the way to the front.
They're getting close, yeah. Think you could still do an ILS back to Olympia, though?
I think so.
Especially when
turn it back on here.
When it's dark, it's actually easier. But you can see the lights so much better for the runway.
Yeah.
I always feel like once it gets daylight, then even if you do the ILS, you're gonna have a hard time seeing.
Yeah. Oh, we should be fine.
Coming there. Foot traffic.
Sam 23 to command post. We've cleared out the encampment.
Now they just have to clean up the mess.
Yeah.
But the actual camp is clear. Still watching this group up here on the street.
TRV SWAT Command.
Go ahead.
Hey, do you have WSP around you up there?
Negative. We got one WSP unit and probably about 20-25 black shirts out here.
Carlos, how's your...
Go.
You know, let the guys in the TRV know we're in a minivan watching them. We've got a contactor.
Copy. Looks like we're adjusting some resources now.
Oh, that's probably where...
Claridge Coleman. Move back to the SWAT vehicle. We're going to move up to the TRV.
There's six of us. Carlos Rubin.
Go ahead.
Be closer for us to walk to the TRV. Do you want us to just do that?
Affirm. We just want to get some people up there.
Copy. We're moving.
So there's a pretty, decent sized group. I don't know, 20 or so.
Confirm your
the onlookers.
Overpass. Yeah. And that's where the closest officers are. They're up there. So the crowd is kind of getting, I don't know, not very confrontational, but.
Ruben, when you get up there, will you coordinate with WSP and see if we can get them pushed at least past the front of the TRV?
Copy.
they're going to try to push these folks back here. They're forming up a line.
Hey, Brian, Rod. Sam 23, Sam 4.
Go ahead.
Can you communicate with whoever the state leader is and push them off of the bridge and beyond where we're going to be walking right underneath of them?
We're taking care of that right now.
36, thanks.
Yeah, that's what they want. They just don't want to walk underneath them.
Okay.
Hey, Rod, Ruben.
Go ahead.
And just be advised, up here on the top of the bridge, right here on the right, I don't know if you can see any point, there's some kind of tent encampment right there.
Yeah, BNSF is going to clear that.
Hey, Rod, Ruin, there's another one on the opposite side up above.
Okay, is there somebody that can get up there, because we're not going to be able to with the wall here?
Copy, we'll check it.
Alright, so there's their line. That guy seems pretty fired up there.
Oh, yep.
Everybody else is more or less just standing around, but he's the one who's doing a lot of angry waving and...
Radio 4420 traffic.
Got there a box or a bag.
Rod, it's clear up here.
Received, thanks.
Carlos Rubin.
Go ahead.
All of us are going to be at the...
Copy that.
Yes, now they just have to wait around until they finish clearing out all that stuff.
Yeah, I think so.
I count 22 or 23 of them up there.
Okay. Looks like they're kind of on the sidewalk, or they kind of a little bit.
They're in the middle of 7th, basically. They're not being too disruptive. But nobody could drive down 7th anyway, because there's
all the
stuff, so.
Does that one pull up for you? That's the distribution list we usually use for emails.
Okay, let me see.
Start typing it in, it might work. Nope, then a dash. Do a dash. That sometimes takes a second.
Yeah, that bicyclist is acting as their scout, I think.
Okay. Yeah. I just have to manually enter it later.
Yeah, because then I can save it as a favorite.
Yeah, so did you just get the email from the LT?
1063.
Yeah.
Reorient myself here. Let's see, there's DOL. I get all confused.
Let's see.
I got it here.
Okay. I can see it.
I was all turned around because I wasn't paying attention to which way I was facing there.
I need to send one. I got it. My thing here.
Oh, it worked. Okay.
Well, I went on your email.
Oh, and just save
there,
that.
And then I just opened it.
Okay. Yeah, there's another one too. It's aviation section, so that'd be everyone, but that's just pilots.
Oh, okay.
When you send your departure and landing emails, you do that one. All quiet at the 1063.
Oh, yeah. There's nobody even close to that anyway. Even the other end of the tracks that come out of this tunnel, there's nothing going on there.
What's 1063?
That's the new headquarters building.
Oh, okay. realize that sometimes they have the running lights, the airport going, and other times they don't.
Those, the pilot controlled ones, they only stay on for about 15 minutes, and then they'll go back to off, so you just need to reactivate them again.
Oh, so the white lights that are running constantly, you control that from up here?
Yeah, like the runway lights, is that what we're talking about?
Right.
Like the little strobes at the start?
Right.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah, if the tower was open, they would control that themselves, but...
Interesting. Okay. And that's how you use it with the mic button there, and you can
Right
number, dim
them. Yeah, 3 for low, 5 for medium, 7 for high.
Oh, okay.
One walking westbound on Legion coming up behind you.
Maybe a few more now, but not much.
Go.
Can you check with the CP and make sure they're okay to bring the public works equipment onto 7th from Cherry? They just didn't know where they were supposed to go, and they're asking if they can come in here. I don't have a problem with it, but I just want to make sure that's
7th and Cherry, not sure where they're supposed to go. Is it okay for them to come in from 7th and Cherry?
Yes.
All line to Gilda House, yes.
Gilda House, copy.
That is correct. They can come in from 7th and Cherry. Also, for all units, WSP is going to take their bomb detection dogs through just to make sure that there's no surprises.
Copy.
County 4, CM 23.